Okay, so here's a song that I think is the most beautiful song possibly that Brian May has ever written. And it's sad, but it's got a beauty in the ache that I really, really love. And you may have never, you probably have never heard me sing. What's, say again? Did you say something? I'm hearing things. All right.
I'm just the pieces of the man I used to be. Too many bitter tears are raining down on me. I'm far away from home, and I've been facing this alone for much too long. I feel like no one ever told the truth to me about growing up and what a struggle it would be. In my tangled state of mind, I've been looking back to find where I've been wrong. Too much love will kill you if you can't make up your mind. Torn between the lover and the love you leave behind. You're headed for disaster, 'cause you never read the signs. Too much love will kill every time. I'm just the shadow of a man I used to be. Seems like there's no way out of this for me. I used to bring you sunshine. Now all I ever do is bring you down. Yeah, how would it be if you were standing in my shoes? Can't you see that it's impossible to choose? No making sense of it. Every way I go, I'm bound to lose. Oh, yeah, too much love will kill you. Just as sure as none at all. It'll drain the power within you, make you bleed and scream and crawl. And the pain will make you crazy. You're the victim of your crime. Too much love will kill you every time.
Key, we're just hanging out.
Going where the wind is blowing, holding on to let it go. I know it, That's how I got this far. Running while the world was walking, dreaming while the rest was sleeping. Solo, you can only go so far. Way up high, I'm just another man. Knock me down into your arms again. Say the word and my love will follow. Say the word and my love will follow.
Then it goes like this.
Just say the word, just say the word, my love. Yeah. I've built me the kind of reputation that gets me anything I'm craving, baby. I'd trade it all for you. Ooh, just like that, won't even skip a beat. Drop my plans, live like we were meant to be. Say the word, and my love will follow.
You just
say the word, and my love will follow, follow,
follow.
Just say the word, just say the word, my love. Hey, and darling, you're the only girl that I'd follow around the world, around the world.
Way up high, I'm just another man. Knock me down into your arms again.
Say the word, and my love will follow. Yeah, yeah, around the world like there's no tomorrow. I'll follow, and this is how we go. Sing, ooh, ooh, that's right. Yeah, just say the word, just say the word, my love. Come on now, sing with me. Say the word, say the word, say the word. Say the word, say the word, just say that you can. Say the word, say the word, say the word. Just say the word, just say the word, just say the word.
Ooh. Woo! How's it going, everybody? Here I am. Thanks for hanging out with me. From the comfort of my own little studio in my home in Nashville, Tennessee. So we're going to move on to another song. I'd like to play another one off of my Impersonator album. Is that all right?
Sure.
Or should we skip that?
Whatever you want to do.
Oh, whatever I want to do. That's very exciting. All right, this is a love song I wrote for my wife. And traveling with down here, they all got married before I did, so I got to observe their marriages before I got married. And by the time I got married in 2010, I felt like, I got this. And then I realized that I don't got this.
I won't back down, got you dead in my sight. All spoils to the crown, two for wrong, one for right. Intimidation won't faze me. My ammunition sound, and I won't break this stalemate. Nobody wins, can't take your eyes off the other sins. Stalemate. We're just gonna wait here, betting each other that we won't pull the trigger. Darling, don't pull the trigger. Across state lines, retreated to a safe house. Playing bad cop, to a truth that ceases to amaze me. How lovers can be so crazy. Just gonna wait here, letting each other back. We won't pull the trigger. Stalemate, oh, stalemate, darling, don't pull the trigger. Stalemate, oh, stalemate, darling, don't pull the trigger. Can we escape this tired rhythm? What if we give up the right to be the victim? And just surrender together. Stalemate. Nobody wins. Can't take your eyes off the other world and sins. Stalemate. Are we just gonna wait here, letting each other that we want? Darling, don't pull the trigger. Baby, don't pull the trigger.
Would you love my life? Or we can go into play again.
Yeah, let's yeah, we're going to do some Queen song, another Queen song. But here's one that you haven't seen me perform yet. It's I've started performing it with the Ultimate Queen Celebration. And it's a song that I've always loved by Queen and just never got around to singing it. Maybe because it's one that I love. A lot of people like it, but it's maybe not in the canon of their greatest hits, although I really think it's a greatest hit. So I'm totally fine. I'm not emotional. It's just I get swept up in the moment with these songs. I wrote that one for my wife, and I love her very much. Say what?
What if you made yourself emotional over the music? That would be amazing.
I did. I made myself emotional over the music. Fine. Thumbs up to that. It's good. You got to feel it, you know? So it's a Queen tune, right? And it's in the same key. If it sounds like it's in the same key, it's because it is. So,
open up your mind and let me step inside. Rest your weary head and let your heart decide. So easy when you know the rules, it's so easy. All you have to do is fall in love, play the game. Everybody play the game of love. Resistance is low. Light another cigarette and let yourself go. This is your life. Don't play hard to get. It's a free world. All you have to do is fall in love, play the game. Everybody play the game. Oh, waters. My love is running through my veins, driving me insane. Come, come, play the game, play the game, play the game, play the game.
How's everybody doing? Hanging in there? I love that song. The best way, if I had to pick to support an artist, concerts, physical media, or streaming. Unless you stream all day long one single artist, then you're probably contributing a bit to them. But the revenue from streaming is a fraction of a fraction of a fraction of a penny each time you play a song. So only the very biggest artists these days are making a profit on Spotify and all the other streaming services. I don't mean to single out one, but the best way you can support an artist is go see them live, buy their albums, whether you buy their music online or buy the physical CD. Buying the physical CD at the concert that you're watching them at is the best way, because not only are you paying for the ticket, you're also paying for the money, and they get it right there. So that is definitely the best way. Buying any of their merchandise, t-shirts, whatever they have on the tables, that is the best way. But I understand the convenience of streaming, and it's kind of hard to fight that these days, but that's my answer to that. Meeting the Queen guys, I was much older. I was 35, I think, when I met Roger Taylor and Brian May. And so, you tend to be less influenced by meeting famous people. But, there was still a little bit of, whoa, finally meeting the guy. Like, people have been telling me I sound like Freddie for so long. And that journey had finally somehow taken me to the source, the guys who were in the band who played with Freddie Mercury on stage with him for 20 years. And I was finally meeting Roger Taylor. And a few months later, I met Brian May in Los Angeles when he came to help set up the guitar tones for the Queen Extravaganza, because we were in our initial rehearsals for our American Idol appearance. And I was almost more starstruck to meet his guitar, the Red Special, honestly. I was just chatting with Brian, who's a lovely, lovely man. And he's for something that is so priceless, his Red Special guitar, which he built with his dad, he's so not that careful with it. It's a piece of rock gear, and he's been playing it for 40 plus years. And he said, "Would you like to hold my guitar?" And I was like, "Yes, please." So I strapped on his guitar, and I was very nervous. And the neck of the guitar is much, much wider, much fatter than guitars I'm used to playing. And so I just strummed it a bit, and I'm like, "Thank you, sir. Here's your priceless piece of rock history back. So that was a funny moment. Back in the day, a lot of the greatest artists, like Frank Sinatra and, lots of people became great artists by singing other people's music. And that's something I'm just kind of learning now late in my career. that there's nothing wrong with singing other people's music. Of course, you know me from singing Queen. But, you know, I grew up being a singer-songwriter, and I just played you a couple of my own tunes. But I'm really starting to love playing other people's songs and making them my own, because I just love to sing big songs. This might be a train wreck, because I haven't played this song in years, literally years. And I'm not confident that I know it well, but it doesn't matter, because it's a silly song. And if it goes silly, we're all good. So back when Down Here started, my old band Down Here, fond memories with those guys. And welcome all of you who know me from that. When we first started, we started a band in college in Saskatchewan in 1999. And there was this other band called Sweet Salt that was also based out of our college. And they were marketing geniuses, and we were not. And something that they would do in their shows to get people, to convince people to spend money on their merchandise, their CDs, their T-shirts, their posters, and whatever, was they wrote this silly song called Buy Our CD. And it always went over gangbusters with the teenagers and whoever was there. And they sold just a lot of merch. And we were like, man, when I say merch, that's industry speak for merchandise. So they were selling so much merchandise, and we were doing shows, you know, and we felt like we were doing really great shows, yet our merchandise wasn't selling very well. And we needed that. We needed those sales to buy, you know, fuel to get to the next show and, you know, all of that stuff that a rock band needs to survive. So we decided to copy Sweet Salt and make our own merchandise song. And at the time, my brother was also in college, and he was surviving on bologna sandwiches, literally, because it's the only thing he could afford. And so he ate basically nothing but bologna sandwiches for lunch and dinner for about 2 months, until he realized that his skin was turning a little bit disgusting shade of green. And so he told me that story over the phone one day, and I was like, man, that's so sad. I'm so sorry, brother. You know, I wish you didn't, you know, you could survive on something other than bologna sandwiches. And so that gave me the idea that rock stars can't live on bologna. And so based off my brother's personal struggle in college, I wrote a song called Rock Stars Need Money. Rock stars need money. We can't live on bologna sandwiches. Rock stars need money, and it comes from you. Rock stars need money. We can't live on bologna sandwiches. We can try, but we'd really rather not, you know. Rock stars need money. We can't live on bologna sandwiches. Need money, and it comes from you. And you, and you, and you, and you. Hey, rock stars need money. We can't live on bologna sandwiches. We could try, but we'd really rather not, you know. So, buy my album, ooh, or a poster, a sticker, whatever. Just help me get through the week and make these EPs. Rock stars need money. We can't live on bologna sandwiches. Rock stars need money, and it comes from you. And you, and you, and you, and you. Hey, rock stars need money. We can't live on bologna sandwiches. We can try, but we'd really rather not, you know. 'Cause rock stars need money. That's not the way the song ends, but I forget how it goes, so I'm gonna end it like this. And you. That's how. Oh, no. So close. I had it. Almost had it.